What was it like from your perspective? I mean, you're home, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. Did this start with a knock on the door? Was it a phone call? Was it a pounding? What actually happened last night from what you can tell us?
Yeah, and I'll be happy to go through detail by detail. So I was sound asleep. Of course, never expected anyone to be coming to my house at that time in the morning. Heard some knocks on the door, heard my doorbell, saw some lights outside, heard people outside my windows in my yard. And I jumped out of bed, threw my clothes on, and I picked up my gun. That was my instinct, because I'm a gun owner. I'm a Second Amendment supporter, and I believe in defending myself. And normally I answer the door with a gun, especially if it's someone that I don't expect coming to my home. But for some reason, I had this weird gut instinct to not take my gun with me to the front door, which was very out of norm for me. So I put my gun down and I just went down the hallway, and the house was still dark. And I came around the corner and looked out the windows, and there I saw the police outside, and they had their guns. They were ready because they had received a terrible phone call to the 911 center. And so I walked up there and I saw them. I was really startled, and I couldn't think, like, why are they here? You know, did something bad happen? You know, that was what I was thinking. I thought maybe someone had been hurt or killed, and they were coming to talk to me about it. And I opened the door, and the officer standing there, he said, "Ma'am, are you okay? Is everything okay here?" But it was the body posture of the police that was really concerning me. Like, it had me even, I was upset. I was afraid. I was like, there's something terribly wrong. And I said, yeah, I'm okay. You know, I was sleeping. You know, I'm like trying to understand what they're doing. And he said, hold on, let me get my sergeant. And then they came from around the corner and came up the steps and told me that someone had called in to the 911 call center here in Rome, Georgia, and had reported that someone had shot either her husband or her boyfriend 5 times in the chest in a bathtub. And then they were sending the police to supposedly go help. But then they called back a second time and said, there's children in the home. There's children in the home. So with those phone calls, they were setting up a very serious, dangerous scenario in a home, right? And police officers, when they get those kind of calls, they know what they're going into. They have to be prepared for it. They have to get there immediately. It sounds like they made it sound like there were children in danger at our house. And so the police officers, they got to my house so fast. But then I said, no, this is all wrong. I said, come inside. I brought them inside. I said, you know, they said, yeah, we realize what's happened is you've been swatted. And they were upset, rightfully so, and angry. And I was very upset. I could not believe someone would do that. And I was shocked because not only did they put my life and my family's life in danger, they also put the police officers' lives in danger. And so whoever this person is, they deserve to be locked up.